you have any idea how much water I'd be drinking?
Yeah.
Lake Erie would be gone. Every day you want me to drink that?
Yay, yay.
I drink some water. I ask for water. Everybody's nice. We'll get Dr. Lori water.
I don't know.
French fries go in easier. Don't you think?
Dehydration, bad
problem. Chocolate's good too. There's got to be some chocolate, some water in chocolate, right?
No.
What do you mean, no? You're not helping my cause, but you're thin. I'm not.
I'm not thin.
Susan, baby, how did you acquire this? I want to talk about chairs.
We bought a set.
You bought a set of chairs.
One captain's chair, five without the.
This is a captain's chair? Why is this a captain's chair? Did a captain sit in it? Because it has arms. Armchairs are usually called captain's chairs, right? Sometimes they're larger than others. What kind of chair is this? I'll give you some multiple choice. Is it Chippendale? Is it Queen Anne? Is it William and Mary? What kind is it? You have no idea. You think it's Queen Anne, why?
Because of the...
That's right, because of the capriole legs. You see those capriole feet? A nice curve of the leg. I don't have that anymore. When I used to swim, I used to have that curve of the leg. I don't have that anymore. That's gone with the breaststrokers, done. But that nice curve of the leg here, and then that rounded foot, that's capriole, right? Now up here, what you have are actual elements here. You see the vase? Looks like a vase here. You see that? You see this? Where it looks like two birds in profile, this is their beak. Do you see that? That's a Chippendale thing. So what you have here are two different and distinct styles or patterns that have been united, right? This part is Chippendale, the bottom half is Queen Anne. Chippendale is popular after 1756, Queen Anne is popular before 1756. Are you getting all this right? Write this down, Steve. Let's go, write it down. So that's what you're looking at. This is made by a particular company, the Sykes Company of Buffalo, right? And it's marked on the bottom, a reproduction chair. Reproducing two distinct 18th century styles. So you bought the armchair, and you bought how many other chairs?
Five chairs
that don't have arms.
Right.
Five chairs that don't have arms, that are the same shape, the same decoration.
Yes, and we have this like sticker, and it's.
I don't care about the sticker.
Okay. I'm
trying to find out what you have. You have side chairs that have no arms.
Right.
Without arms, it's a side chair because it goes on the side, right? It goes on the side of the table. Armchairs usually go at the ends or the head of the table, right? Okay, and you found the sticker. You're saying, oh, the sticker's very important. The sticker is important. It indicates that this particular chair is made anytime between 1895 and 1925. Value on this chair right in front of me, about $300. The other side chairs, if they're in the same condition, about $150 each. The table, I'd have to see a picture of the table. If you change the upholstery, it doesn't impact value negatively or positively, depending on how well you actually have the upholstery done. Oh, okay. So if they do a lousy job, it decreases the value. Make sense?